seconds cover the top four cars, and just 3 seconds further back, Oliver Jarvis coming across the same traffic. He may make a better line through it, but first and second, Richard Westbrook, no cars now between him and Filipe Albuquerque, and the Acura closing in. Definitely an advantage at that point on the circuit as he catches the race leader going into that Le Mans chicane. And of course, at Le Mans, the first chicane in 2022 onwards, it will be in a reciprocal arrangement, the Daytona chicane. Got to get used to it, but even before the start-finish line, it's nose-to-tail between first and second. This is a move going around the outside, always off at the outside. Filipe Albuquerque, can he make it stick into turn one? We've seen two moments where he just simply hasn't got it done. He's got his nose in front now, but they're turning right into turn one, Johnny. Who's it going to be?
Well, this is the best chance that he's had so far, and look on the, even further on the high side. Well, Kevin Magnussen is slotting into second position, I think. Yes, ahead of Richard Westbrook. So Magnussen was trying to read that situation as best he could, and Westbrook thought, well, I've got one car that I need to deal with. I'm not sure I can wrestle two back. And in fact, Westbrook loses two spots from the tri-oval. He was down to second across the line by 9 thousandths of a second, and then went on to lose second position as well to K-Mag, who is late on the brakes into the Western Horseshoe now, because Magnussen not only up to second place, he's not happy with that yet and wants to take the race lead away from Filipe Albuquerque. I have to say, the number 02 car looks to be really in the sweet spot from Chip Ganassi Racing.
It really does, and I do so feel for Richard Westbrook there. He nails his colours. I'm holding the inside line. If you're coming past, you're going on the outside, and unfortunately the two GT class cars just didn't behave the way he wanted to. He had no option but to hit the brakes a little harder. That allowed Albuquerque to complete the move, but of course Magnussen also on the outside line swept by, so all those laps. But let's see, how does Westbrook react? But right now it's Albuquerque going away with Magnussen right on his tail. Just need a wider shot to see actually how far back has Richard Westbrook dropped, but I think the simple answer will be maybe a second in arrears. But certainly the pace at the moment of Albuquerque and Westbrook is mighty. Albuquerque, the Portuguese ace, spent lap after lap trying to find a way past Westbrook, and when it broke the lead advantage, it just went very quickly, and it wasn't Westbrook's fault at all. You've got to guess. He guessed one side, it didn't work his way. But it is yin and yang, and we'll see what happens over the following few laps. But it's a fantastic battle in the cold, cold night at Daytona International Speedway. But right now, it's Filipe Albuquerque on the top of the pile, but only just.
Just shows, though, how much Albuquerque and Kevin Magnussen were being held up by Richard Westbrook. You can have pure pace on the racetrack, but you need to have the gap made, whichever way that is done, either by traffic or just good driving to get your competitor off the ideal racing line. But already Albuquerque, having set a 135.6, that is significantly quicker, 2 seconds worth, than Richard Westbrook. And Kevin Magnussen could be even quicker than the Portuguese in this phase of the race, because the 02 car looking for a way by. Virtually every corner looks mighty coming out of turn six and up onto speedway turn one, and it's good on the brakes into the Le Mans chicane as well, as the gap really condenses as they turn left and right and over the curbs.
Little microcosm at this point. Last lap, Filipe Albuquerque, 1:35.632. He was the fastest driver on that lap. Who was second fastest? It's a driver in 11th place, a driver in a P2 class car, René Rast. That's a fantastic lap in P2 from the German ace. He's running, what, 6th in the P2 class. That's the car's fastest lap of the race, but that is a brilliant lap. Must have had no traffic in front of him. He's got quite a distance to catch up with Ben Keating, who's the next car in the order. But just these little moments, when you get a different colour on your timing screen, it stands out. And we were eulogising about the pace of the first two drivers, Albuquerque and Magnussen, and the fact that a little bit further down the order in a car that shouldn't be as quick, René Rast did it just as well as they did. And that was car number 68 for G-Drive Racing by APR, one of the two Oricas they've got in the race. So well done to René.
Yeah, and he's now clear of the stray DPI that is still behind the wall. Two of them, remember, the 01 of Sebastian Bourdais, the 48 of Jimmy Johnson. Jimmy into the garage because of damage after he clashed with the GT car coming out of turns one and two, and both of those cars, still an unidentified GT car, but we think it may have been the number 16 Wright Motorsports Porsche, ending up on the central grass of the Western Horseshoe, and Jimmy Johnson having to limp home with damage to that rear right corner. And Sebastian Bourdais, a drive belt which has caused an issue, an alternator belt, which is proving very troublesome to change, and that 0-1 car yet to emerge, which appeared at the stop initially as to be routine maintenance, but it's proven to be much more tricky to solve than that since. The 10 car, Filipe Albuquerque, well to the high side of a couple of cars, so again three abreast as one of the GT machines peels off out of Speedway Turn 4 and heads for pit road for a green flag pit stop. 134.259 was Albuquerque's last completed lap. That was lap 409, and that is the number 10 car's best lap of the race so far.
Interesting, isn't it? How hard are they prepared to push at the moment? They've got a few laps under them since the yellows were withdrawn. We went back green. Fantastic racing. But Albuquerque and Magnussen, yeah, they've got a second over Richard Westbrook. Mike Conway, another second, 1.2 seconds down. And Oliver Jarvis just not quite matching them in the Meyer Shank Racing number 60 Acura at the moment. But you know how the teams talk about get to midnight, get to morning, get to noon, see where we can go in the last 2 hours. But I tell you what, getting to morning here tomorrow, today, of course, today already, will be just that moment where a little bit of sunshine will come up, maybe, or maybe it'd be grey, but just a bit of temperature is what everybody craves, not just for keeping people comfortable in the pit lane and those who are being so hardy. Fantastic crowd here this weekend for the 60th running of this fabulous event, but it is hyper cold at Daytona, and you just have to feel for those who only pack one little t-shirt to put under their race uniform.
Side by side, heading down to the chicane, and that was Magnussen with some contact, taking the lead. Where on earth did he come from? And Richard Westbrook is going to pick up the pieces as well, with the move to the outside of the 10 car, and the 5 then of Richard Westbrook, because Albuquerque was off the racing line, had to go to the outside to get by Albuquerque, and that move is still not done yet, as now it is. Because as they thread their way through GT traffic, the 0-2 to the race lead, Kevin Magnussen from so far back, Mike Conway's getting stuck in as well in fourth position. So Conway now pursuing Richard Westbrook and Filipe Albuquerque down to second.
So Albuquerque, yeah, just hold on to that second place, but it was a dive bomb from Kevin Magnussen into the Le Mans chicane, and suddenly Mike Conway was sitting just a second, two seconds off the pack. He's right in the mix, but you have to look some distance up the track, because not only did Magnussen take the lead, but the sort of coming off the power, trying to regain the line there for Filipe Albuquerque and trying to resist Richard Westbrook means you've got the leader, Kevin Magnussen, a second and a half, and then three cars, nose to tail, Albuquerque, Westbrook, Conway. So it was all change.
So Kevin Magnussen looking like he was happy to settle to be in the draft of Filipe Albuquerque, and then at the last possible moment, it's not often you prevent Albuquerque from knowing exactly what's going on.